88 stars Catherine Isabel as Gwen, a woman who wakes up on the side of the road with no recollection of how she got there or anything else before that. But she comes into contact with this other guy, and this guy lets her know half of the situation. And that takes her down this violent journey to find out who killed the love of her life and why, basically. And Christopher Lloyd plays somebody that she knows in said life. Now, the movie is kind of divided between two different storylines. You get the present storyline, then you get the flashback of storylines. You get to see how she got to where she is, basically. And I must say, Catherine Isabel is a fucking joy to watch in this movie. Not only did I like her in See No Evil 2, where she was that crazy, over-the-top, sexual doll character, but I like her in here because I like how she acts in this movie. She acts pretty damn good in this movie, especially between the situations that she's in, and it's fucking awesome, okay? Christopher Lloyd, man, this guy is getting old, man. I love Christopher Lloyd. I love him as the villain in this movie, not like Star Trek and not like Roger Rabbit PG villain. No. This is hard R-rated villainry as his best. He breaks a man's jaw and then sews it shut. That's awesome. Okay, I don't think I ever seen Christopher Lloyd this deep before. I don't think I ever seen Christopher Lloyd pop the F-bomb before. So that's even another more awesome than Pierce Brosnan dropping the F-bomb in The November Man. But, yeah. But man, about time you play a good bad guy that I actually like. You're not getting any younger, Christopher. I mean, damn, you can barely talk, but still, you're awesome. So, yeah. The other actors in this movie does okay. There comes a situation where they're coming to this lady who is an arms dealer, and she is just silly, over the top, but she's funny, and I like it. I like how this movie has a little has a sense of humor, excuse me. And you got this dark, serious tone, and then you got this other humorous side to it. I actually enjoy that a lot more. Which is, it makes out for a very nice 88, pun intended, minute movie. That's funny that the movie is called 88 and it's 88 minutes. Damn, that's kind of funny. But yeah. Overall, 88 is a decent action mystery thriller, if you will. I'm not going to give 88 a B. Let me know what you guys think about 88 down below. Did you like it? Did you hate it? And I'll catch you guys in the next one. By the way, if you notice that I'm doing a lot of independent movies for 2015, yeah, I decided to take a newer route to it. Not only review all the big movies, but review all the sideline movies as well. See if there's any surprises to that. And that's the point of reviewing movies for me, so yeah. Anyways, I'm out.